for this week's review of The Incredible Hulk, starring Ed Norton.
You have to get as far away from me as you can.
Go!
There are aspects of my personality that I can't control.
Target is in the overpass.
And when I lose control, it's very dangerous to be around me.
The name of this movie is The Incredible Hulk. I would have called it The Do-Over. It's hard to imagine a movie made just 5 years ago has already been remade, and this has to be a Hollywood record. And there's only one reason I even went to see this remake, and his name is Ed Norton, who is in my opinion one of the most talented actors in the business today. And without him in the movie, I don't even bother seeing this until it comes out on DVD. The most interesting thing about this movie was it doesn't start at the very beginning. It starts after the entire experiment has already taken place and shows only minimal flashbacks. Now this is quite a surprise, but they do make it work pretty well. What is not surprising, however, is that this film was able to get some great actors in it. But this movie did have an exceptional overall cast. Tim Roth, or as I like to call him, Mr. Orange, was a brilliant choice for the arch rival of the Hulk. It was also nice to see the original Hulk, Lou Ferrigno, in the film as well. And for all you MMA fans out there, they had the legend himself, Hicks and Gracie, as Bruce Banner's Aikido instructor. The cast was easily the strongest part of this movie. The acting was also solid like you'd expect from such quality actors. The only problem some people will find with this movie is the length and the pacing of the film. While it doesn't ruin the movie, it does keep it from flowing at a nice pace throughout the film. The CG is pretty good, but at the same time they replace a Spider-Man with a CG Spider-Man, sometimes you don't know which is which. But with the Hulk, sometimes it's just hard to believe the Hulk is really Bruce Banner inside, and I doubt this will ever change. Once you know the character is 100% CG, it takes a little away from the emotion and the vulnerability of the character. The key to this film, like all others in the superhero genre, is how will the climax and the final battle play out. Now they did a better job in this movie than many others. While it's not the greatest, it's not a letdown either. Sometimes it is a little hard to keep focused because things are moving so fast. Now I would say the ending was fairly predictable, but not disappointing. Overall, this movie is a well-made, fun popcorn flick that will be enjoyable for people who like the genre. But if you're not a superhero movie fan, you might want to skip this one. This is not in the same league as Iron Man. While it is a good film, it's not going to capture some of the people outside the core demographic. Also, this being the second Hulk movie made in the last 5 years is not going to help ticket sales after they've seen the debacle known as the Hulk. So for those of you that are on the fence, if you have any interest in seeing this film, check it out. You should enjoy yourself. For my overall rating, I give The Incredible Hulk 3.5 stars.
You'll shoot your eye out, kid.